In this video, we're gonna find out, can we make a front-wheel drive car as good in the snow as an all-wheel drive car using three different types of traction aids? We have three different traction aid solutions to see if we can get the Civic up a hill quicker than the Grand Cherokee in the snow. Now let me introduce you to our most affordable traction aid. This was $38. It's an interesting idea. This is just essentially a rubber block that straps around your tire and is supposed to help you get up snowy environments. Now, coming in at $70, we've got the good old fashioned tire chain. We're gonna see how this compares to all-wheel drive. And then lastly, probably the most expensive and certainly the most novel, tire sock. This is supposed to slip around your tire and give you some additional traction for climbing steep hills. So we're gonna find out which one is the best, which one is the easiest to use, and if any can out-accelerate an all-wheel drive Jeep. The Jeep Grand Cherokee is rolling on a set of Pirelli Scorpions. Now this is an all-season tire, mud and snow rated, but it's not a dedicated snow tire. Just like the Honda Civic. Now this Honda Civic is rolling on a set of Continental all-season tires, but once again, not a dedicated snow tire, just mud and snow rated. So this is the all-wheel drive test vehicle, the 2021 Jeep Grand Cherokee. Now this has a full-time all-wheel drive, or if you want, a four-wheel drive system. All right, Alex, are you ready for the acceleration test? Let's see how quickly this Jeep can drive up this snow-covered hill.
We're ready, throttle down.
All right, full throttle in 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, Jeep. Okay, so the all-wheel drive system working well. You can see and you can hear the traction control system, the V8, the 8-speed automatic, and the four-wheel drive system struggling for grip.
14.51 seconds in the Grand Cherokee.
All right, so from an acceleration standpoint, we're gonna try to get that Civic to beat 14.51. The front-wheel drive car for our test today is this, the 2022 Honda Civic Sport Touring. What we're gonna do is just put it in a drive, traction control everything in normal mode, just like we did with the Jeep. I'm just gonna try to get up this hill as fast as I can. All right, in 3, 2, 1, full throttle. Now, of course, only the front wheels are fighting at the snow. Traction control is really limiting our progress right now. It's trying to distribute power as best as it can. All right, I may have to do traction control off because we are not going anywhere. Come on, traction control off. There we go. There we go. Okay, we got some movement. Sawing at the wheel. Almost 5,000 RPM. Now, of course, this is a difficult test because we came to a complete stop at the start of the hill. But I think we might just make it. Vehicle stability control disabled. That's reading 33 miles an hour, but that's probably more like 15.
1 minute and 5 seconds.
So if we compare all-wheel drive to front-wheel drive, that is, well, it's nearly 4 times as long to get up the hill.
Yeah, that was pretty much exactly what I expected. Didn't think you were gonna go anywhere for a little while, so. Yeah, let's throw some traction aids on these tires.
Hold up for a sec. Before we get going on the traction aid tests, none of the companies shown in this video have paid us anything. This is not a sponsored video. We actually went out and bought every traction aid just like anybody else would. None of these were given to us for free. So this is our first and most affordable traction aid. Now, this is very much a generic product off of Amazon. These were like $38, but the way they work, I don't know, it seems kind of clever. Let's see how they work in practice. So essentially you've got these straps and these little rubber blocks. And what this is gonna do is essentially strap onto the tire. This is going to go on top of the tire and then give you some additional traction to help you get unstuck. Although I'm not really sure that this is gonna be much of a benefit when it comes to actually accelerating over a long distance or even stopping. So Alex, these have absolutely no instructions whatsoever.
No, they look pretty self-explanatory though.
Yep. So this is basically gonna go through the spoke of the wheel. Of course, this is not gonna help you if you don't have spokes in your wheel. But I will say, they do seem to be really easy to use. I suppose that's just gonna cinch down there against the sidewall. All right, we're trying to drive over to the test area and this is miserable. That is 12 miles an hour and that is, I think, as fast as I wanna go because there is just one provided per wheel, which I guess could help you get unstuck, but oh, you wouldn't wanna drive on this, would you?
This is terrible.
Oh, that's brutal. Now, I have seen solutions where they have like kind of more profiled versions of these where they have multiple per wheel, but these were like the affordable ones and one per wheel might help you get unstuck, but
I'm just worried we're going to mess the fenders up on this beautiful Civic.
I am too, actually.
Not a lot of clearance in there to stuff a big block on your tire.
All right, so the most affordable traction aid, the one block per wheel at $38 on Amazon. I don't feel super confident in this, but we'll see how they accelerate up the hill. Alex, are you ready?
Ready for you.
All right, I'm going to accelerate in 3, 2, 1, up the hill. Okay, now a little bit of slipping and then the blocks catch and then they stop catching. Oh, the whole car just kind of rocks back and forth. I mean, it was better. We were able to get going quicker than just with the tires itself, but anything more than 10 miles an hour and the car feels like it's gonna rattle apart, that cannot be good for the car. So, I'm trying to keep it pointed in a straight line. Ooh, it feels bad in the steering wheel too. Here comes the line. Right about now.
38.13 seconds.
38. Now, I probably could have gone quicker, but right at about 10, 12 miles an hour, these things feel like they are going to rattle the car apart. So I was being pretty ginger with them.
Yeah, that sounds good. Let's not break the car. These are definitely low-speed traction aids to kind of get you unstuck. Definitely not for highway driving or anything like that.
All right, so next up we've got an Icon, the good old-fashioned radial tire chains. Now these were about $70, and it's worth noting you do have to fit them to your vehicle, so they make them in different sizes, and then there's a little tire chart here that tells you what size tires each bag fits. So these are as closely matched as I could to the Civic. We're gonna try putting them on and see what the process is like, and also if it helps with snow performance.
Stop. Definitely not as easy as the first thing we tested.
Just make sure that we're all squared up.
So look, he like hooked it through and then he like used it as a ratchet. So Alex, what did you think of the chain install?
It was pretty terrible. It was very slow moving. We had to do some research on the side of the road. If you're in the mountains, you might not have cell service. Wasn't fun.
Well, the first thing it said in the owner's manual is to install the chains when you first bring them home in the dry. Do you think anyone's ever done that?
No, I had chains in my Grand Cherokee for 4 years. I never opened the bag.
That is exactly how it goes. And then you open it when you need it, yep. And you struggle for 20 minutes like we did. One thing I will note too is as newer cars have these more and more low profile tires, these are really quite tricky to install so you don't scratch the wheel. And it was, in this case, very difficult to install, and the little ratcheting system on this design was really not very well engineered. And then of course you drive it around, you have to retighten it. Now the chains themselves are about $60. We did buy these additional bungee tethers, which are supposed to be assistive in keeping them nice and tight. Those were another $10, a total $70, and they were quite tricky to install, but let's see how the traction is up the hill. All right, accelerating in 3, 2, 1, go. Wow, okay, so lots of grip. Now, they do say you do have to be careful with wheel spin, so I'm not gonna simply plant it. You do hear the chains making quite a bit of noise. All right, so there's 14 miles an hour, but even in the deep snow, feel really pretty good. Oh yeah, lots and lots of acceleration traction here. And here we go across the line now.
25 seconds for the chains.
so we cut off a considerable amount of time compared to those little cleats.
Now, you are only supposed to use chains up to about 30 miles an hour, but I am not super confident in these with the low profile wheels. I think we might damage either the wheel or the inside of the wheel. So I think we move on to the sock. Now for the most expensive traction aid in our test, the auto sock. I've seen these all over TV and all over social media, and apparently they're pretty good, but we're gonna find out today. Now, once again, you do have to match the auto sock to your tire size. There's a full chart right here, and they of course do give you some warnings and some liability warnings on how to, you know, keep them working. But these are the most expensive, coming in at $99, so $100 for this device. And in theory, it's just this fabric meshy material that goes over your tire, and it's supposed to be even better than a chain. They've got these little acceleration graphs here, which try to prove that they're better than not only standard tires, but chains. Let's see if that's true. So in theory, the auto sock application should be quite simple. This is just gonna slip over your tire. We'll see how that works in practice, though. So, per the user's manual, you just wanna get it started. Stop there. Get forward. Stop there. On. Well, so using the forward and stop there technique, we were able to slide them on. Now, they were easier than the chains. The chains took, what, 20 minutes? This is probably 5-6.
Yeah, and still a two-person job.
And I think that if you did chains regularly, you could get them down. And if you did these regularly, you could probably get these on pretty quick. But the fabric or mesh socks are on. Let's see how it does up the hill. All right, so first impression of the auto sock. What did you think of the install?
It wasn't as easy as I thought it was gonna be. Pulling those out of the packaging with just one little elastic loop, I thought it was gonna be on in 30 seconds, but wasn't as easy as that.
Now, once again, the auto sock is tied to your vehicle's tire size, which is probably why it was tricky to get on, because it's gotta still grip the tire. Now, they are certainly a lot quieter than chains. We are not getting that crazy kind of slapping sound or the typical chain clinking.
You can't, I mean, in the passenger seat, you can't tell anything's on the car right now.
But these are still supposed to be speed limited, so just like chains, you don't want to go much over 25, 30. But we'll see what that means in our acceleration test. All right, so the auto sock. Now, they are the most expensive, coming in at $100. And then, of course, 70 for the chains with the little tensioners, and then 38 for those blocks to strap around the wheel. Well, let's see how the auto sock compares. So once again, I'm gonna try to manage my wheel spin. Don't just wanna plant it so I don't damage the sock. I'm all lined up. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Ooh, good traction off the line. I would say pretty comparable to how the chains did, actually. That felt really, really good. All right. There we go, we're almost up to 20 miles an hour. 23. Oh yeah, and across the line.
18.35 seconds.
18.35, is that what you said?
Yep, you got it, 18.35.
Oh, that's so close to what we did in the Grand Cherokee. Let me try it one more time. Let's see if I can get it even a little bit quicker.
Sounds good.
So we are very close to the Grand Cherokee's time up the hill. I'm gonna try one thing, turn traction control off. I know we're not really supposed to get a wheel spin with this auto sock on, but I'm gonna try my best to feather it, see if we can do a little better. Alex, are you ready?
Yep, let's do the second run.
All right, I just gotta shave a few seconds off and we might be able to beat the Jeep. So I'm gonna accelerate in 3, 2, 1, here we go. Come on, not too much wheel spin. Don't want to break the sock. Right on the edge of traction here. Come on. Come on. There we go. We're about to approach 30 miles an hour. 28, 29. There. Across the line.
Pretty consistent. Within a second of your last run, 17.84. So just a little bit quicker. Not quite as quick as the Grand Cherokee.
All right, so that's as fast as I'm gonna go with the sock on. I was starting to get some pretty serious amount of wheel spin, but not a bad result. So we couldn't quite match the Grand Cherokee acceleration uphill using the traction aids, but which of the three was your favorite?
Definitely the sock. I did not think it was gonna work. It looked super silly to me, but it was relatively easy to get on, and I think worked the best.
Yeah, it did work the best, but don't think, even though we were a few seconds away from each other, front wheel drive to all wheel drive, that this is a permanent solution, because AutoSock says that you only want to use these at speeds under 30 miles an hour, which doesn't help you at 31 miles an hour.
Yeah, and if you're stuck with front wheel drive, as we proved last year, snow tires are probably your best bet.
Snow tires are definitely your best bet, and I would take all wheel drive with snows compared to four wheel drive with all seasons. And actually, maybe that's a video we will do here shortly. So in this video so far, we've focused on acceleration and uphill acceleration, which is great, but of course, snow performance is also about turning and braking, and there's a lot more testing we can do on that front. But just as a quick little aside, let's see how these two vehicles brake. So first, the Grand Cherokee, of course, all season tires, then the Civic, all season tires, and then let's put the winner of the comparison on the Civic and see how they perform, the Auto Sock.
So now for braking, what we're going to do is hit the braking target at exactly 25 miles an hour going downhill, and we're going to see how the Grand Cherokee comes to a stop. Of course, we are just using all season rubber on this Jeep, so there's 25 miles an hour about to hit the braking zone going downhill right now. Okay, full on ABS there. There's 5 miles an hour and we made it to a stop. So I'm gonna mark this distance and then we're gonna see how it compares to the Honda Civic. So the downhill performance in the Honda Civic, there's 25 miles an hour now. I'm excited to see what's gonna happen because of course going uphill all wheel drive matters a lot. Going downhill braking, probably not as important to the front wheel drive aspect of this car. So there is exactly 25 miles an hour and hard on the brakes, full ABS. And that's a stop. Let's see how we did. Well, that felt pretty good. So of course the Civic is significantly lighter than the Grand Cherokee. And let's see if that is reflected in braking performance. Oh, and a big margin. So we stopped right here. That's my little marker there just for now. 27. We stopped 27 paces shorter with the Honda in compared to the Jeep, which stopped right there. That is a huge difference, and it just goes to show, although having four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive will help you get going, maybe help you turn, it certainly won't help you stop. But let's see if we can make that even better using traction aids. So with the Auto Sock, I do want to try a braking from 25 miles an hour, see if we can do better than the stock tires. I'm gonna brake at the cone, which is right about now. Ooh, look at that. Pretty good braking performance with the Auto Sock, of course, full ABS. But yeah, let's see. So we stopped right here. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 paces shorter than where we stopped with just the all season. So we did see some pretty serious braking improvements with the Auto Sock as well. Well guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, this has been Tommy
and Alex.
We'll see you on the next episode.